Red Hat OpenShift AI is a portfolio of products to make AI, ML, and intelligent applications an achievable reality for modern enterprises. We've had lots of exciting updates, and today I'm going to give you a quick overview. Let's take a look.
There are a lot of improvements and new features in OpenShift AI. One of the most significant is in GenAI inference. For operations engineers looking to deploy and monitor models at scale, OpenShift AI makes fast, efficient, and scalable inference easy. In addition to deploy models safely, OpenShift AI also supports guardrails for model deployments. While lots of large language models will run well in OpenShift AI, Red Hat validated models are a good place to start deploying tested and verified models, including many of the world's most popular open source models. Deploying GenAI models has never been easier. Let's deploy one of these models from the UI. As you can see, OpenShift AI supports serving on a variety of accelerators, including Nvidia, AMD, and Intel. Model deployments are highly customizable, allowing users to configure resources, accelerators, authentication, and model parameters such as context length. You can also serve from various storage options, including OCI, PVC, and object storage. While we use the UI to deploy the model, the underlying Kubernetes objects are also easily accessible for automation such as Helm and GitOps workflows. For AI application engineers, it's easy to connect and build applications safely and securely using the latest open source models using the same API you're familiar with. We'll simply use the model connection information in our application. For AI ML engineers and data scientists, OpenShift AI provides a complete platform to explore data, experiment, and customize models. This includes workbenches, pipelines, and model deployments. Workbenches are where you'll start a development environment such as Jupyter notebooks and VS Code. The Red Hat supported notebooks offer a variety of frameworks and hardware accelerators. You can also create your own custom workbenches to standardize across your organization. When starting a workbench, I can customize the size, accelerators, storage options, and connect to data sources. Let's add image generation capabilities to our chatbot. We'll take an open source model, customize it using our own data, and then serve it as an API. Once it's served, we'll integrate it into our chatbot application. So let's start off by trying out our new image generator. We're downloading a model from Hugging Face and using the model directly in the notebook. Now let's generate our first picture. So it looks like we're successfully generating pictures. While that's great, I want pictures using my own personal brand. This model doesn't have any idea what that looks like. What I want is an AI model trained on my data. So instead of just a regular dog, we'll use my dog. So this is Teddy, and we want to generate his picture. But the model doesn't have any idea what Teddy looks like. So using pictures of him as our data, we'll fine-tune the model. Now that we've got the data downloaded, we can configure the training job and kick it off. This is using a single GPU for training, but if I wanted, I could have created a distributed PyTorch training job that would use multiple GPUs across multiple nodes in my cluster. So this is going to take about half an hour on a single GPU, so let's come back after it's done. After the training job is complete, we can reload the model and test it out. There you go. Now you can see the model is now generating pictures of Teddy. Now, to do this in a repeatable manner, we can create an AI pipeline. A pipeline ranges from a single notebook to lots of conditional steps. Once we've triggered a pipeline run, we can view its progress and recreate as many runs as we need. We can even change parameters for each run to experiment and find the best model. Now that we've fine-tuned our model, we need to integrate it into our application. We can do this by serving the model as an API. Earlier, we used vLLM. Since we don't have a pre-built model server, I've added a custom serving runtime for diffuser models. Now I can configure our model as I normally would. Here from the dashboard, we can deploy the model and point it to the location of the fine-tuned model on storage. After the model is deployed and ready, we can copy the endpoint details and configure our application to use the API. So now, our chatbot application is configured to use our own hosted large language model and able to generate custom images using our fine-tuned model.
That was a quick tour of Red Hat OpenShift AI. Our goal is to make your data science projects successful not just as experiments, but as part of the next generation of intelligent applications. I hope you found this brief introduction useful, and we have a ton of new features coming. But for now, I can't wait to see what you create with Red Hat OpenShift AI.